Hello everyone, this is Kesh. I'm coming to you today with a makeup tutorial. So this is the look. It is a matte soft cut crease neutral eyeshadow and it features two lip colors. The first one is a nude lip and this one is a bright lip. The lipstick that I'm wearing is Wet n Wild Don't Blink Pink. I have decided that I will be doing a series of neutral eye makeup looks because I believe that it doesn't matter if you are into light makeup or heavy makeup, everyone should learn to do a neutral eye because it is very versatile. It can you can pep it up to make it glamorous, or you can tone it down to make it suitable for work, business, or any other event that you may have. You can pair it with a bright lip, you can pair it with a nude lip, you can just pair it with lip gloss depending on your preference. So a neutral eye is one of the most important looks that everyone who is into makeup at all should learn to do. And if you're not into makeup, it is also good that you learn a neutral eye, because when you are at the point where you actually want to wear makeup, if you have a special event or so on, a neutral eye is perfect for those days. So if you want to see how I created the first look in the series, my series of neutral eye makeup looks, just keep on watching. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, share with your friends, and please thumbs up this video. Thank you for watching. Okay, so the first thing I'm doing is I'm adding a skin tone brown powder all over my lid and crease, and that is my transition color. Right there I am taking a blending brush, a smaller blending brush, and I'm using a reddish brown color, and I'm placing that right above my crease area, and that will give the eyeshadow a gradient effect. Next I'm taking a black eyeliner and I'm drawing where I want my cut crease to be. And if you notice, I'm not drawing it exactly in my crease, I'm drawing it a little bit above because I have hooded lids, and because of that my lids will fold a little. So I'm drawing it right above the crease to make my lids look larger than they actually are. I am taking a dome shaped brush and I'm taking that dark brown color, and I'm just going to blend out that line a little because I don't want it harsh. As the title says, it's a subtle cut crease, so I'm just going to blend out all of that right there. And one thing though, this does take a bit of time because it has a lot of blending, so you have to blend. So right there I am just blending out the eyeliner, and because this is like a cream kind of liner, it does take a little while to blend how I really want it to. And it did get a little bit messy, but I'm just going to use my fingers to just wipe it off a little. And what you can do to keep yours from getting messy is place a bit of clear tape right there, or I do believe that e.l.f. sells the little thing that you can place right under your eyes there so it does not go over. Next I'm taking my eyeshadow base, which is a white eyeshadow base by NYX, and I am placing that all over my lids, so that will help my eyeshadow to stick and to make the color appear brighter, because the color that I'll be using on my lids, it is a mauve kind of earth tone, so it's not a color that you'd normally use on dark skin and it would pop, but because of the white base it will appear a bit brighter. So I am going to take that mauve color from that palette right there, and I will be placing that all over my lids right where I want it to be. And if you notice, I'm going to patting it on so that the shadow, so that I can get maximum pigmentation from the shadow. So I'm just patting that on, and I'm patting it all the way to my actual crease, and sometimes I like to take it a little bit higher if I want my lids to appear larger than they actually are, because as I said, I have hooded lids, so my lid does not show the color most of the times.
right there I'm using my pencil brush again, and I'm going back over that line that I had for my cut crease, and I'm just blending that out. And I am using that bronze eyeshadow to create a gradient effect at the outer view of my eyes, just to darken it a bit, so that it looks a little bit more smoky, because I do not like the flat look of the mauve eyeshadow only on the lids. And with any eyeshadow, one of the most important things is to blend, and that's exactly what I'm doing with that brush. Blending. Right there I am adding a bright gold to my inner tear duct, and the reason I'm using gold and not silver is because gold makes my eyes pop. So I'm using gold. So gold goes well with my brown eyes. And I'm also going to drag a bit of that gold onto my lower lash line, about a quarter way. And then I'm going to do the rest. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just adding the shadow. I'm also using the same gold that I use in my inner tear duct as my highlight. And as I said before, it is a bright gold. Next, I am using a black eyeliner. I think that is the Maybelline Master Drama. And I'm just placing that in my waterline. And I'm going to use that same dark brown that I used in the crease to just smoke out the black eyeliner just a little. Not too much, because we don't want to look like a raccoon. We just want a little bit of eyeliner to be smudged. I will be using two mascaras in this because I will not be using any lash. So the first one is the Maybelline Stiletto mascara. I really like this one, and it gets my lashes. But my favorite mascara is this one right here, and this is the Maybelline Great Lash Mascara. And this one also works well with my lower lashes, and my lower lashes are really short, so this one helps to get them so that they show up a bit more. And as I said before, I'll not be adding any by the way, I did add some eyeliner to my lids off camera. So right there I am placing my bright pink blush. I'm blending it into my contours. As you can see, this does take a bit of time also if you're blending it into your contours, because you want it to look as if it flows rather than it just sitting there. That's the Ioni Cosmetics bronzer duo, and I'm actually using the darker side, and I'm placing that right above my blush. And as you can see, my face is a little bit round, that's why I did not place the blush on the apples of my cheek. And I also added some of the lighter highlight from the palette to my nose. For my lips now, I am using the LA Girl Plum lip liner, and I'm double lining it because I want to my lips to pop some more, and it also helps with this color that I'm adding to my lips. This color is a Maybelline, sorry, it's a LA Girl lip glaze. It's the only one that I own, and I think I'll be buying some more because this one is really nice. And the color is Elude, and I'm just adding that to my lips. By itself, this color does not work for me, but with that lip liner, it really makes it looks really nice. So that's what it looks like with the nude lip. So if you want to pair this look with a nude lip, it would look something like this. Right there, I am using my NK lip liner, and that is pink. Bright pink, I believe the color is called, and I'm doing the same thing I did before. And this right here is my favorite bright pink lipstick, and it is Pink Don't Blink by Wet n Wild, and it's a very pigmented color. And I must say, it is a bright, shocking pink. So if you're not about showing up like that, and you don't like the attention, then this lip color is not for you. So this is the one that I This is one of my favorite lip colors. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.